Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our science film practical on mineral types. Now, this corresponds to activity number 13 within your book, where what we're asking you to do is have a look at four different minerals, have a look at their shape, and draw them and to identify them. And there's probably a couple of big ones that we should really be able to remember. So let's have a look at them. The first one we have is a substance which is the softest of all of the minerals, and that comes from Mohs hardness scale. Is basically talc. Now this one, the talc is contained within the rock, and it's those white bits that are contained within there. But that's talc, and it's sort of, it's light, it's you can scratch it very easily. You can turn it into powder, as in talcum powder, very easily as well. So that's basically talc there, and that's the easiest of the lot to have a look at. I'll bring out the next one, which is quartz. Now quartz is ranked 7 on Mohs scale, and you can see there that they start to have definite crystal shapes. So you can see the sort of crystal shape that is here, okay, with it. So again, I'd also get on the internet, have a look at some better samples and better quality pictures around quartz. But that's your basic quartz, relatively hard, so it will scratch anything above it on the periodic table, so talc and gypsum and the like, but won't scratch anything below it, which is why most hardness scale is actually recognized. At number 4 on most hardness scale, we have this one here, which is fluorite. Okay, and again you can see the sort of material that it is, the sort of the color. You can start to see the crystal shape, because that starts to become quite important. I wonder if I do that actually makes it a little bit easier to see. So you can see there that, and if you look inside, you now start to see the crystals that are forming. So that's number 4 on Mohs scale. This one here is number 2. This is a substance called gypsum. Okay, we make gyp rock out of. So again, you see up close there, you're starting to actually see some of the different shaped crystals in which are present. And each mineral has a different crystal shape. Then we can sort of look through what else have we got. We got some feldspar here, okay, and feldspar comes in at number 6 on the scale. Actually, that's the talc one. Put it in the wrong section. This is number 11. So this is the feldspar here. Okay, so it's relatively hard. You can start to see, that's the overall shape, but the shape that we get it in isn't obviously the shape of the crystals. That's lots and lots of crystals joined together, so you end up with the sort of unique crystal structure. So there's not really a lot to talk about in relation to the minerals. But one interesting thing is that we do a practical activity that revolves around crystal shapes, and this is what some of the shapes that my year 8 class has done this year, which are actually quite good. So we've got shapes like diapyramids, and that's this one down here, for example, has two pyramids that sit on top of each other, and that's a zircon. Has that particular crystal shape. We have a monoclinic, which looks like a 3D parallelogram. That's this one up here. So your gypsum will give you that particular shape. You have a rhombic prism, which essentially just looks like a 3D square. So you've got it there, which is orthorhombic crystal, and a substance called topaz had that. Haltite is a basic cube, so you can have a cube. You've got a hexagonal prism here, okay, and this one here is a hexagonal diapyramid, because again, hexes means you've got 6 faces, and you've got the 6 faces on both sides, and this is a octahedron, which 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so it's got 8 shapes there. And we have a triclinic, which sits down the bottom there. So different crystals, and the point of this one is different crystals have different shapes. That's basically some of the major things. So again, if you need to get on the internet, have a look at the different pictures of the different crystals. There are some quite stunning photos on the internet, obviously. They're far better ones than the minerals that we have here as examples, as really close up of the crystals. Then if you haven't already, make sure activities number 13 is complete. If you need to, go and talk to your teacher about the practical if you're not sure on anything. Thank you for accessing Warwick Sciences Film Practical on minerals.